Hey guys, welcome to this comparative analysis session by Intellipaat. In this session, we are going to compare and contrast data scientists and data analysts. In this data-driven world, we need valuable information to make a business successful. To obtain that information, we need data scientists and data analysts. So in this session, we'll be comparing them. Now, before moving on to this session, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our upcoming videos. Now let's take a quick glance at the agenda. So we'll start off by learning the need for data. After that, we'll be looking into what a data scientist does. Moving ahead, we'll be learning what a data analyst actually does. After that, we'll be looking into the skill set of a data scientist versus a data analyst. And finally, we'll be learning about the future scope and salary of a data scientist as well as a data analyst. Now, without any further delays, let's begin with the session.
Starting with, why do we need to handle data? So, we'll understand the need of handling data with the help of an example, a real-life example of Google Maps. So, you all must have used Google Maps in your day-to-day lives for traveling from one place to another, for knowing the destination, for knowing the route for the destination, the distance, the time that you would require to reach the destination. Also, this Google Maps shows us the transportation system. It gives us the fare for different transports, different modes of transports. So it is a wonderful application of data science and machine learning that helps us in our day-to-day lives. So how do this application predicts so accurately? So this is all with the help of real-time data. So you can understand that how important data is. So if you have an Android phone or an iPhone with Google Maps open and services enabled on it, then your phone or the application sends real-time data back to Google. Then Google uses this information or data to calculate how many cars or vehicles are there on the road and how fast they are moving. So as more number of people start using this app, the traffic becomes more accurate. Google also collects the data of traffic from various applications that monitors the traffic reports from the local Department of Transportation. Then it also keeps a history of traffic patterns on a specific route so that it can predict the traffic at a specific time and on a specific location. So this application majorly uses data, rely on data to show us the best results it can. So Google Maps suggests a faster route to reach our destination on time if the traffic is more. So it uses real-time location. If you are feeling like Google is monitoring and tracking your every move, then you can opt out anytime by turning off the location services. But what if everyone did that? Well, Google would be in trouble then, as the data and the result might not be accurate. And this is the reason why at some places Google Maps is not so accurate. So the world all it revolves around data, which helps us to get the experience of such wonderful applications. Now, who is a data analyst? So going on to the definition of data analysis. So data analysis is a process of inspecting, cleansing, transforming, and modeling data with the goal of discovering useful information from it, informing conclusions, and supporting decision making. Basically, data analysts collect, process, and perform statistical analysis of the data. And their skills may not be as advanced as data scientists, but their goals are same: to discover how data can be used to answer the questions and solve problems. So a data analyst's job is to take the data and use it to help companies make better business decisions. And this could mean figuring how to price a new material for the market, how to reduce transportation cost, solve issues that cost the company. So a data analyst basically looks at some data and try to make sense out of it. So for example, if sales are going down, so what do? You check through the dashboards or query data from your database using SQL and find out which category suffered the most. Then going deeper and find out other factors is the task of a data analyst. They perform analytics on the data to know what is going wrong and then talks to the product manager with the evidence to how to fix that problem. So this is majorly the task of a data analyst.
Okay guys, a quick info. Intellipaat provides an end-to-end training on data science with R and Python, and if you're looking for it, you can check out the details in the description. Now let's continue with this session.
Now we'll look at the roles and responsibilities, starting with designing and maintaining the data systems. So they collaborate with the data engineers to design the architecture that efficiently helps them to fetch the data and the information from the database. Then mining data from primary and secondary resources for the organization, and they extract relevant information or relevant data for the organization. Then using statistical tools to interpret data sets, they perform statistical analysis on the data to analyze the data. Then analyzing and visualizing the data are the majorly one of the important tasks of a data analyst. Then finding trends and patterns in the data to know the insights of the data. Then preparing reports that effectively shows the trends, patterns and predictions using the data. Then implementing business analytics to understand and optimize the business by making effective strategies. Then collaborating with programmers. Maybe they can be machine learning engineers, data engineers, or data scientists or software developers to make them understand the business requirements. Then recommend system modifications and improvements by analyzing all the conditions and situations of the business. Then develop policies for data governance. Now moving on to the next part, we'll look at who is a data scientist. So going on to the definition, a data scientist is a professional who extensively works with large data sets in order to derive valuable business insights from it. So data science is basically an interdisciplinary field that uses scientific methods, processes, algorithms, and systems to extract knowledge and insight from many structural and unstructured data. So the field of data science is majorly related to data mining, machine learning, deep learning, big data, and artificial intelligence. So talking about data scientists, so data scientists are big data wranglers and gathering whose task is to gather and analyze large sets of data that can be structured or unstructured. So data scientist's role combines computer science, statistics, and mathematics majorly. So they analyze and process the model, they model the data, then interpret the results to create actionable plans for companies and other organizations. And also data scientists are analytical experts who utilize their skills in both technology and social science to find trends and manage data. They use industry knowledge, contextual understanding, skepticism of existing assumptions to uncover solutions to business challenges. And a data scientist's work typically involves making sense of messy and unstructured data from various sources such as smart devices, social media feeds, and emails that don't neatly fit into a database. So data scientists are the game changers. So all the applications, all the interesting applications such as Google Maps or recommendation systems of various websites that you can see, these all are applications of data science, and these are created by data scientists. So now we'll look at the roles and responsibilities of data scientists. So starting with collecting large amounts of data and analyzing it, then using data-driven techniques for solving business problems, then communicating the results to business and IT leaders, spotting the trends, patterns, and relationships within the data, then converting the data into compelling visualizations so that they can understand the trends and behavior of the business, where it is going, then deals with the clients for gathering requirements for their business, designing algorithms for machine learning models. So they collect the data from various sources or maybe from data analysts and look into the data in the context of creating a machine learning or automated model using various machine learning algorithms. Then they are also involved in deploying machine learning models with the help of machine learning engineers, and they are involved in the task of iteratively improving the model by providing them the quality data that the model needs to learn. and working with artificial intelligence and machine learning techniques are the basic and very important role of a data scientist.
Okay guys, a quick info. Intellipaat provides an end-to-end training on data science with R and Python, and if you're looking for it, you can check out the details in the description. Now let's continue with this session.
Now we'll understand the difference between a data analyst and a data scientist. So starting with data analyst, so we already know data analysts collect data from various sources, or they can be primary or they can be secondary sources. They pre-process the data, they clean the data, manipulate and also visualize the data. They perform big data analytics on the data, they create reports. Then a data scientist collects the analyzed data and looks it with an angle of creating such a process that helps in building automated models, that helps in the prediction for the business. And also the task of a data scientist is to analyze and visualize the data and decide about which algorithm should be used. So this is the major difference between a data analyst and a data scientist. Now moving on to the next part, that is we will look into the skill set of data scientist and data analyst. So starting with data scientist, so a data scientist should have knowledge of SQL, that is the structured query language used for databases, then Tableau or Power BI, that is used for data visualizations. So they must have knowledge of these two tools in Microsoft Excel. Then going to the programming languages, they should have a comprehensive knowledge of Python as well as R. So there are various libraries in Python and R both, various libraries and packages that are specifically used in data science, machine learning and artificial intelligence to analyze and visualize the data, to create machine learning models, create automated models. So they should have knowledge of both these languages. Then mathematics, a data scientist must have a thorough knowledge of mathematics, especially statistics and probability, linear algebra, calculus, differential equations, because these are used for creating machine learning models. Then data pre-processing, manipulation and visualization, these are the basic tasks of a data scientist. So they should be thorough with data pre-processing, manipulation and visualization tasks. Then machine learning algorithms. So they should be an expert and in implementing various machine learning algorithms on the data sets so that they can create models, predictive models out of that. Then they should have knowledge of artificial intelligence, which includes neural networks and deep learning. The knowledge of neural networks and deep learning is very important for a data scientist to know. Then obviously software engineering, they should have knowledge of software engineering as to build work on various softwares, creating softwares. Then finally, they should be a good problem solver. Now moving on to the next part, that is skills of a data analyst. So they also should have knowledge of SQL, that is structured query language, then Tableau, that is used for data visualization, and Microsoft Excel, then programming languages. They should have knowledge of Python or R, that is used for used by data analysts to perform various analytics techniques. Then statistical knowledge is must for a data analyst, as statistics is used for analyzing the data and applying statistical techniques to understand the insights of the data. Then a data analyst should also be a good problem solver to analyze the business problems, to solve the business problems and make effective strategies for increasing the revenue generation of a business. Then ability to analyze, model and interpret the data. Then they should also have a knowledge, basic knowledge of data science, then machine learning algorithms, so that they can collaborate with data scientists and ML engineers for building predictive models. Then comes creating dashboards and reports for the organization so that everyone can understand about the trends and patterns of the business data, to know the insights of the data and to understand in which direction the business is actually going. Now we will see the job scope and salary of data analyst and a data scientist. So starting with data analyst, according to Forbes, in India, there are 5,000 plus jobs available for a data analyst in 2020. And talking about United States, the number of jobs are more than 12,000. So you can see there are a plethora of career opportunities in the field of data analytics. Talking about average salary, so in India, the average salary of a data analyst is 7,50,000 per annum, and in the United States, it is $1,15,500. Then moving on to the data scientist, talking about number of jobs, according to Forbes, in India, there are 10,000 plus jobs available for a data scientist in 2020. And in the United States, the number of jobs are more than 25,000. So there is a wide scope of opportunity in data science field also. So people who are willing to become a data scientist, so there are a plethora of opportunities that you can grab. So talking about average salary, a data scientist earn an average salary of 9,35,000 in India, and in the United States it is $1,32,000. In this video, we understood why we need to handle data, what is the importance of data with the help of the example of Google Maps. Then we looked into the roles and responsibilities of data analyst and data scientist. Then what are the skill set that makes a data scientist and data analyst. After that, we understood the difference between a data scientist and data analyst. And finally, we looked into the job scope and salary of both these profiles. So this is all you need to know about the difference between a data analyst and a data scientist.
Okay guys, a quick info. Intellipaat provides an end-to-end training on data science with R and Python. And if you're looking for it, you can check out the details in the description. Okay guys, we've come to the end of this session. I hope this session was helpful and informative for you. If you have any doubts or comments, you can leave that in the comment section below and we'll love to help you out. Thank you.